Hi, welcome to part 3 of module 8. Congratulations, you've made it to the end. In this part of module 8, we're going to be focusing on how do we put all of this together within a DBI or intensive intervention framework. So our objective for this part is to see how the entire DBI process works. Can you see I'm excited about this? I am. All right, so here is our DBI framework. So let's talk through this framework in a little bit of detail. So remember first, we have our instructional platform. We talked a lot about the instructional platform in module 3. So if you want any more information about that, I hope you'll go back and check that out. But within the instructional platform, the first few things that we do is we conduct a diagnostic to understand student strengths and weaknesses. Then we take that information and develop a scope and sequence. Remember that continuum of mathematics learning that we talked about in module 1? This is where we bring that knowledge in. And then we identify the instructional platform, whether based using an evidence-based intervention or an evidence-based strategy. Remember, everything has an evidence base that we want to put into our instructional platform. Then we implement that instructional platform. We should implement it frequently. So our suggestion would be 3 to 4 times a week for approximately 20 to 40 minutes a session. And remember, we can't implement anything without fidelity. And we just talked about fidelity in this module 8, so I hope it's fresh and on the top of your mind. Now, after we implement that with fidelity, we want to make sure that it's working for students. So we continually progress monitor students. Our recommendation is that this should occur weekly. And you want to use reliable and valid assessments. We talked a lot about that in Module 2. And we set goals to see if students are on track to meet those goals or if students need an instructional change. Now, when we think about the response to intervention, for after 6 or 10 weeks, we want to determine whether students are showing adequate response. So students that are showing adequate response, we're going to continue with this awesome program that we have designed. But for students that are not showing adequate response, then we move to this part of the DBI framework. And so it's here that we conduct a diagnostic looking at students' strengths and weaknesses. This might be a more in-depth diagnostic than the one that you worked on up here, because we really want to get at where does this student need the most help? Where can we help them the best? And that diagnostic determines the adaptations that we make here. Remember, we talked all about adaptations and also another part of Module 8. But then once we implement those adaptations, we're going to do that frequently. So again, 3 to 4 times a week, at least 20 to 40 minutes a session. This has to be a concentrated effort. This can't be something that we just do once a week. And also, as we implement those adaptations, we need to make sure that we're circling back and assessing the fidelity of which we're implementing those adaptations. And then as we implement any adaptations, we want to see, like, well, is this working? So we do progress monitoring. Our suggestion is that it occurs weekly. We are always using reliable and valid assessments. I wouldn't let you do anything else. And then we set those goals and monitor students' progress toward those goals. And then every 6 to 10 weeks, we should check in and say, like, well, is the student on track? Are they meeting goals? Or does the student need another set of adaptations? And that's why we can continue with this process here. So this is everything we've learned about DBI and mathematics. That's a whole lot. And here's the breakdown of where we learned these things. So in Module 1, we talked kind of just like an overview of DBI, and we talked about developing the scope and sequence for an intervention. In Module 2, and this is green because it matches with these assessment pieces here, we talked a lot about progress monitoring, we talked about diagnostics, and how to determine whether students were responding in an adequate way. Now in Modules 3 and 4, We talked about how do we find evidence-based practices, and we then took some of those evidence-based practices and deep-dived in Module 4 into the delivery of instruction. So we focused on explicit instruction, good, concise language, and multiple representations, and we continued the evidence-based practice description, I guess would be a good word for it, in Module 5, where we talked about building fluency, effective problem-solving instruction, and the importance of a motivation component. Now, in Modules 6 and 7, we still continue to focus on instruction. Here, we focused on whole number content and then rational number content. And then with Module 8, we really brought back some of our assessment decision-making in place. So we looked at fidelity and adaptations. And so this has been our progress through all these modules. We have done such an amazing job. Now, if you're also wondering where the content is for each of these little parts that I named, I'll go ahead and say the instructional platform we talked about in Modules 1 and 3. Remember, we did lots of instructional stuff across Modules 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Progress monitoring was a big hit in Module 2. Response to intervention was also in, we also talked about that in Module 2. Diagnostics we talked about in Module 2. And then the adaptations, we really emphasize those in 8, but you may want to go back and think about some of that instructional content in 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then finally, we talked more about progress monitoring down here. It's pretty much the same conversation, but in Module 2 and the response there in Module 2. So I hope you could, you know, maybe take a screenshot of this or a nice picture. So if you're like, oh, where was that content? I want to go back and review that, or I want to dig that out and dig deeper into it. Here's where everything around DBI was covered in this math course. So our checklist for this part, remember we were focusing on how does this all come together within a DBI framework? So you need to develop that instructional platform, implement progress monitoring, determine whether students are benefiting or need some instructional changes. Then, if necessary, conduct a diagnostic, make those adaptations, implement them, and then always to continue progress monitoring as necessary. So your activity number 6 for this module is to create your plan for implementation of DBI. So I've given you a very loose DBI diagram here. So here's kind of like what we expect. And then I'd like you to make some notes. What's your instructional platform? What's your progress monitoring? How do you make decisions? And then do the same thing with number 3. What's your diagnostic? What are your adaptations? And then what's your progress monitoring and decision making? And then after you finish that, I'd like you to move to your discussion board where you share your excitement and concerns, if you have some, about starting or continuing DBI. Thank you so much. See you soon.